We are just about 9 miles from downtown Manhattan as EA Sports brings you to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with Derek Carr and the Las Vegas Raiders. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line, so bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision, loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
On first down, Carr. Catch is made by Hunter Renfro. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
First down, Raiders.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. Carr completes it, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down. Again, they'll throw with Carr, dancing to his left. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 at the 19. That is caught at the 7. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. From 19 yards away. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. So now Carr, he'll lead the Raiders up to go for 2. Carr now to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. So pretty interesting. They get the opening drive touchdown. They wanted a little more. They were looking for 8, maybe something they thought about before the game started, I would imagine.
I think you're right about that. That's discussed in your staff meeting. A decision is made. I think the head coach has to blueprint it and say, yes, let's go ahead and do that. In this case, though, let's give some credit to the guys on defense. They gave up the touchdown, but found a way to regroup and keep them out of the end zone for the 2-point play.
Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage. Gardner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
A play fake, and it's Darnold. He's going to find his tight end. That's Chris Herndon. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Now the former Terrapin, this is Ty Johnson, and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last 2 plays.
That's another Jets first down. First and 10 at the 20.
Back to the ground, this time with Gore. And not much, maybe a yard down to the 23.
The tackle made by
here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case,
and he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Jets can take the lead now with the extra point. Certainly, there are good things about quick strike offenses that score fast. But a long drive can also work to your advantage as well.
In so many ways, Brandon, because number one, you get them tired. But the big one is mentally. They can't figure out how to slow you down, how to get off the field, how to get the ball back. They go to the bench wondering, what are we going to do next time in order to stop those guys? And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. And he'll drop here to throw. Throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. Carr with a play fake to Jacobs. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jacobs. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Well, prior to that, he had hit his first six passes to start the game, so on a nice little run to begin.
It feels like this offense has carried its dress rehearsal into the game, you know, because you do practice it, you do go through it, and in this case, it is clicking exactly like they drew it up.
Ryan Poole that time there to get a hand on it.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Throwing his car on third down. That's caught by Waller out left side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. First down Raiders, Carr to Waller.
First down.
Into the red zone, it's Carr. Going right side, he has Witten. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Derek Carr fighting the veteran Jason Witten. And once again, the Raiders are back out in front.
The tight end position has always been dangerous, especially in the red zone, short field. But now even more so, because these tight ends aren't necessarily the tight ends of old. They're the rocked up wide receivers who have a little bit more speed, way harder to cover than before.
14, Jets 7.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
He dumps this off underneath to Gore. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
He'll air this one out deep for Perriman. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Here's Darnold. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Off of play action, Darnold. Looking for Perriman, and it's intercepted. It's Damon Arnette picking it off, and he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Second and 6 at the 46-yard
line. Are going to throw. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Patrick on Wasor. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Jet touchdown. So a dangerous dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it, went in the other direction, excellent blocking, and picked up a touchdown.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And no return forthcoming for Richard as this will come out to the 25.
25-yard line.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now Carr to try again after the pick six. Man open, that's Henry Ruggs. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Third touchdown pass now for Derek Carr. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly for six.
The Raiders will line up for the...
And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, get that water break and get on out there and play.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
On second and 10, Darnold looking for Perriman there. He's got him. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
A gain of nine.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
This one now in their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They hand off to their big tight end. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Darnold. He's got Herndon, his tight end. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
And this throw will be intercepted. It's David Arnett picking it off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Jet touchdown.
McLaughlin lining up for the
So now two pick sixes that he's thrown in this first half of play. Where do you go from here?
But number one, make sure you keep your poise. Make sure you go to the sideline after throwing this second one, and you look like you're still in charge, that you're still the guy, because your team's gonna feed off of you. And if you're having your hands on your head or shaking your head, walking with your head down, guess what? They're not gonna rally at all.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no return forthcoming for Richard as this will come out to the 25. Throwing after the interception, Carr, and a slant hauled in by Ruggs. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Carr now on first down. The connection here with Nelson Agholor. And he gets this all the way inside the Jets 20 into the red zone. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Being chased out left. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
A seven-yard pickup brings up second and three.
Now Carr. This will be caught at about the six. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Make it four touchdown passes now for Derek Carr. And the Raiders have retaken the lead.
That could be an important swing right there, a touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first two quarters.
And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
Ballantyne to return. And able to get this out to the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. On first and 10, Darnold. Screenplay, Johnson. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another 18-yard gain. They had 18 on the previous snap as well.
Chase McLaughlin on for the field goal. A 56-yard attempt.
That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Makes it third and four.
Darnold now to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 more there and another first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
He was trying to get it to Denzel Mims that time.
That'll bring up second down.
Leads to second and 10.
Off the draw, here's Johnson. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
That's why the guy with the headsets is down there. All right, they know what they're doing because they got stuffed on a running play on first down. And I think myself and probably the fans were saying throw the football in this situation. But he knew what he was doing, called another run, and now they've got 3rd and short.
The 3rd down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And the gadget play here on 4th down winds up backfiring. And the Raider D, they get the football back. On 1st down, Carr. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by the linebacker, Jordan Jenkins.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, 1st down.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a 2nd interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Sets him up nicely. 1st and goal. It was a pickup of 14.
1st and goal at the 3-yard line.
Back to throw, Darnold. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. From 3 yards out. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. And he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. And we are all tied at 28. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Take over 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Carr and the Raiders come up 1st and 10 at the 20. He'll set up to throw. Got an open man. It's Ruggs. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Right off the bat, it's a 1st down to start the drive, 12 yards.
1st down, Raiders.
Now Carr. He finds Aguilar over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. It's a gain of 20 as we wind down near 20 seconds left in the quarter. And now a throw on 1st down there, but it's incomplete. Henry Ruggs, the intended receiver, but it'll be 2nd down.
2nd down and 10.
To throw again, Carr. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Jordan Jenkins in there to get him. It's a loss of 5.
Now, 3rd and 15.
That is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now call. on the bootleg. And the throw there going to be incomplete. And this is too far behind his man. He missed him. It's incomplete.
Now, fourth down.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. The Raiders do snap it. It's Carr.
Got his connection complete to Ruggs.
And
he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas.
Henry Ruggs.
His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Raiders have moved out in front.
The Raiders.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They'll try to run it with Jacobs. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more.
36. Jets 28.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one possession game, down eight. They'll be looking for the touchdown and two-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Second and seven.
Darnold from the gun. Airing one out for Crowder. And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 41 yards. So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Darnold completes it. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
And that's a much-needed first down right there. Look, they're down by 8. So logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a fourth down situation comes up, I'm thinking hard about going for it right here and right now. For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Braxton Berrios there to make the grab. And the Jets are within a two-point conversion of tying this thing up. They're going to try and run for it. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
Raiders 36. Jets.
So the lead shaved to 2 now as the kickoff is away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your 4-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. Remember, the 4-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario? Get enough first downs and make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football. No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
Now Carr. Able to find Waller. That's complete. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon. Carr to throw again. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. 3 tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Again, it's Carr. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
The defense, they were swarming that time and ultimately got to him before he could get rid of the football and knocked it free.
And don't you feel just a little bit of sympathy for him back there, though? So much going on, so much swirling around. He's trying to find someone downfield. He's trying to move around to find an open target. Sometimes you forget the number one thing, take care of the football.
Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. The throw on the quick slant going to be complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver. And it's second down.
At the 40-yard line.
Throw. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, and what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Now Gore. A gain of three, second down.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got three timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
At the Raiders' 21-yard line.
And they get the timeout called here. It comes with 1 second remaining on the clock. So now this one's going to rest on the foot of their second-year kicker. The clock showing just one tick. This for the win. And it's good. He got it. He missed his long attempt earlier, but he connects when it matters most. And the city will be alive tonight. The Jets have won it. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.